Welcome to another video lecture. In this, I am going to discuss about the vapor compression refrigeration system. Refrigeration means cooling a space, substance or a system to lower or to maintain its temperature below the ambient one. Refrigeration is a process of removal of heat from a space and transforming the same to the surrounding environment. In simple terms, the refrigeration is artificial cooling. We know the water in an earthen pot gets cools. The water in the earthen pot gets cool because of evaporation of water drops coming out of the pot through small pores of the pot. This evaporation phenomena is applied in vapor compression refrigeration system. There are three concepts we should know before understanding how a vapor compression refrigeration system works. The first one is that energy will not flow spontaneously from a low temperature object to a higher temperature object. It means we need some external work to transfer the heat from lower temperature to the higher temperature. The second concept is the relationship between the pressure and saturation temperature. So we know at atmospheric pressure, the saturation temperature of the water is 100. The table shows as the pressure increases, the saturation temperature also increases. Similarly, decrease in pressure also lowers the saturation temperature. If you look at the properties of the ammonia, which is a refrigerant, at atmospheric pressure, its saturation temperature is minus 30. It means ammonia liquid boils at atmospheric pressure. This concept also plays an important role in working of vapor compression refrigeration system. The third concept is the latent heat. So we know that when a sensible heat is supplied to the water and fluid, it starts boiling, and latent heat when it's supplied, there is a phase transformation from liquid to the vapor. Similarly, when the latent heat is taken out of the vapor, the phase transformation takes place from vapor to the fluid. This property is also used in vapor compression system. In this way, the three concepts, external work required, the latent heat and the pressure and the saturation relationship, will help us understanding the working of refrigeration system. In VCR, that is vapor compression refrigeration system, a mechanical device extracts the heat from the space that has to be maintained at a lower temperature and rejects it to the surrounding atmosphere. A medium called refrigerant continuously extracts the heat from the space within the refrigerator, which is to be kept cool at the temperatures less than the atmosphere. Commonly used refrigerants are ammonia, ferron, methyl chloride and carbon dioxide. Nowadays, environment friendly hydrocarbons like propane R220 and isobutane R600A are used. Let's look at the components of VCR, vapor compression refrigeration system. This is a domestic refrigerator. So these are the major components of vapor compression refrigeration system, that is throttle valve, evaporator, compressor and condenser. You can look at the arrangement of these components in a domestic refrigeration system. After knowing the components of the refrigerator, we try to understand how it works. The refrigerant which is entering the evaporator will be at low temperature and low pressure liquid, normally minus 10 degrees centigrade and 246.3 kilopascal. This liquid refrigerant, when it enters the evaporator, it absorbs the heat from the surroundings and it becomes vapor. In this way, the condition of the refrigerant which is coming out of the evaporator will be low temperature, low pressure vapor. So this low temperature, low pressure vapor is sent to the compressor where its temperature as well as the pressure is increased. This is done in order to reject the heat from the evaporator to the surrounding. Otherwise, we cannot reject it. When a high temperature, high pressure vapor passes through the condenser, it converts back into the liquid. but it will be at high temperature and high pressure liquid, normally 37.8 degree centigrade, approximately room temperature, and a pressure of 909.2 kilopascal. This condition of the refrigerant is not suitable to send it to the evaporator in order to absorb the heat from the surroundings. So we pass it through the throttle valve, where the temperature and pressure of the refrigerant is lowered one. Again, the refrigerant with low temperature, low pressure liquid ready to absorb the heat, again it is passed to the evaporator. In this way, the refrigerant continuously circulated in the refrigeration system in order to keep the space or the compartment cool compared to the atmospheric temperature. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe my channel for some more interesting videos like this. Don't forget to press the bell icon.